Hi there, I'm Jack from Twinkl, and today we're looking at a shadows investigation, where your children can learn more about the scientific investigation process, as well as shadows. Before you begin, ensure your learners are familiar with light and shadows, and some of the keywords associated with the topic. This Light and Shadows presentation is a great introduction. It includes the definition of shadows and the definitions of opaque, translucent, and transparent, characteristics of different items that affect the sort of shadow they'll produce, or perhaps no shadow at all. Allow your learners to experiment with making shadows with different sorts of items. How will a translucent object's shadow differ to that of an opaque or transparent item? And this How Do Shadows Change presentation discusses how the size and position of a shadow changes based on the location and size of the light source. It explains how shadows cast by the sun will move during the day as the sun moves. It also explains that a light source up close to an item will cast a bigger shadow than if it was further away. Again, have your learners experiment with this aspect of light and shadow. It's time to move on to this Shadows Investigation Pack, and as mentioned, this activity is as useful for exploring how to run a fair and useful investigation as much as it is exploring shadows. Start with the included presentation and run through how the investigation will work. Lead with the question, how does changing the area of an opaque shape affect the area of the shadow produced? From there, your budding scientists will follow a full investigation. They'll make a prediction and explain their reasoning. They'll closely follow a method. They'll learn all about variables. What is an independent variable and what is a control? And why is the control so important? They'll record their results on a table and then plot those results on a graph before using these results to conclude, comparing against their prediction. Everything is included in the pack to run this investigation, including some scaled shapes to cut out, results tables and bar chart graphs, and even a reminder of how to calculate area. Finally, there are some lower, middle, and higher ability answer sheets, where learners of different abilities can work through the experiment, predicting, noting results, and concluding the experiment. As an extension, your learners can try evaluating the experiment. What went well and what could they have done differently to ensure they got more accurate results? And now your learners have a firmer grasp on scientific investigations, encourage them to lead their own investigation into a different aspect of shadows, like sunlight or shape and direction. Thank you very much for watching. Join us again soon.